like to give a special thanks to Courtney's Cafe in San Clemente for donating the coffee for tonight's game.
Live with Triton Football, it's Friday Night Live. Welcome back, Triton fans, to the fifth game of the season, the 2011 season. Tonight, your San Clemente Tritons take on Newport Harbor Sailors. Please join your Friday Night Live broadcast crew in our eighth year of providing live video coverage of Triton football over the internet. Join Bill Edwards, Mike Andriani, and myself, Jason Diaz, for the play-by-play of tonight's game. Rich Quarter is out of town this weekend. Now, we would like to hear from a word from our sponsors. Our sponsors are Greeks Concrete, Doug Greek, Satuas Council and for Educational Travel USA, Rick Anaya, Little Page Landscaping, Paul, Little Page Automotive, Mark, OC Tavern, Michael Merrigan, Rocco Custom Remodeling, Reno and Greg, South Coast Distributing, Aaron's Family. Welcome to the game, folks.
Great to be with you, Jason. It's a beautiful night in southern Orange County. It should be a great night of football.
Oh, yeah. Not a cloud in the sky.
Folks, you can see our captains getting ready to take midfield. The number 4, Christian Tober. Number 29, Nico Roberti. Number 3, Jacob Graff. And big number 78, Kyle Murphy.
probably sound better. It's his fault. What do we got here? Yeah, thanks. I'm not planning on saying anything all night anyway. What's the damn difference?
What did you say?
I would say, like, brought to you by Paul at Little Big Landscaping. But. I'll handle the kickoff play-by-play.
Okay.
I'll let you. The Tritons have the toss. There he goes. Nick. Woo!
Nick Pasquale found the seam.
Nick Pasquale, the ball carrier.
Nice run.
Tackle by number 16, Zach Wade. 13-yard gain on the play. Triton first and goal.
Pasquale picks up about 13 yards. It's first and five down at the 5-yard line. The Tritons knocking on the door. They're going for the score here. Yeah. Mike tries to cut it outside. Down to the one.
And look like we're going to have another flag on the Tritons. That could be backing us up 15 from the looks of it. I could be wrong, but it looked like Sean Harlow.
You think? Oh, yeah, I see Newport clapping hands, so it might be. I thought maybe the defender came in kind of late, but Newport looked like they were clapping their hands, so it might be against us. Yep, there it is, holding.
The dead ball personal foul signaled against San Clemente. 15-yard penalty. Football spotted at the 16-yard line, second down and goal.
Called personal foul on that. Mike got it down to the one. Now 15 yards back, it's second down and 16 from the 16-yard line. 16, 16 and a half.
Loaded backfield. And Travis is going to roll out.
Looking downfield. Oh, he's going to run it.
Nice tackle near the sideline by number 34, Corey Cablé.
Number 34, Corey Cablé with the tackle.
Looked like Travis had a little bit of room to run, but the Sailor defenders closed the distance pretty quickly.
Yeah, they gave him about 3 yards on that. It's going to be third. They got it marked down at the 14-yard line right now. Travis, shotgun formation. They got trips out to the left. Pasquale coming in motion, going back. Looking, throws the out.
I think that was kind of an ill-advised throw by Travis. The corner was obviously sitting in the flat. That's where Nick Pasquale was going. Gave him a little bit of cushion, but closed the distance. Made the nice tackle on the open field.
Yeah, that was a good job by Newport. Swarming to the ball and making the tackle. With the completion, though, it's 4th and 9 at the 9-yard line. They're going for the field goal. Brett Miller, kick is up.
26-yard field goal by Brett is good. 3-0 Tritons early on.
And so the Tritons got a 3-0 lead right now in the first quarter with 5:36 left. And that score is brought to you by Doug Greek and Greek's Concrete. Not bad opening drive for the Tritons. If it wasn't for that penalty, they would have punched it in.
Yep, most likely. See Coach Allred getting the kickoff unit fired up.
Hey, how you doing? I didn't know you were sneaking in.
Brett Miller's going to kick it off from the middle of the field. Titus Hassan and Corey Cablé deep for the Sailors, lined up at about the 4-yard line. And it's away. Fielded by.
At the 1-yard line.
Titus Hassan at the 1.
Ooh, not.
Nick Pasquale.
Titus Hassan returns the kick to the 15.
Pasquale on the tackle at about the 15. Sailors were trying to set it up a sideline return. They just didn't have the room.
Newport Harbor will be starting at the 15-yard line. First and 10 for them. Let's see what they can do.
And the Tritons in their 3-4 defense.
Cole Blauer under center right now. Looks like they got double tight. No. Tight end shifted. Hand off to the tailback.
Tell you on that play, number 3, Landon Goulet, was lined up to the offensive right side of the formation. And the defensive back was about 20 yards over him. Either they don't respect his ability to catch the ball, or they don't respect the quarterback's ability to get it out there.
I tell you what, that was a good run. Pick up of about 7. almost eight. We second down to three at the 23-yard line right now.
Looks like the Tritons are in a cover
Hand
three.
Off. Goes to the outside. Ooh. And he gets the corner.
You know, Jason, the coaches were concerned about number four, Titus Hassan, saying he was the fastest running back or fastest player, period, the Tritons have faced all year.
Well, he's had two good runs so far. He picks up that first down on the outside. It's going to be first and 10 at the 32-yard line. 4:49 left in this first quarter. Here we go. Back to pass. Oh, almost hey. Picked off. Oh, hit him
Nick
right
Pasquale
in the
Nick Pasquale had a gift, a Christmas present right in his hands.
I think he was shocked by that because that hit him right in the hands. I don't think he expected it right there.
Definite miscommunication between quarterback and receiver because Nick Pasquale had a gimme. And 99 times out of 100, he makes that catch.
And it looks like they got a player down right now.
Trying to get a number on it.
I think it's number 58. I think it's Hunter Duarte, number 58. No, he's standing right over him. 56. Hamilton Randall. That'd be their left guard.
Certainly hope the Sailor player is okay, but it looked like a nice hit from up here.
While we're on this injury break, we'll give a shout out to our sponsors here. Doug Greek from Greek's Concrete, Council for Educational Travel USA, Rick Anya, Paul from Little Page Landscaping, Mark from Little Page Automotive, Michael Merrigan from OC Tavern, Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom Remodeling, the Aarons family from South Coast Distributing. Thank you guys for your sponsorship. Yeah, it is number 56, Hamilton Randall.
Number 56, Hamilton Randall, the injured Newport Harbor Sailor.
And that's our left guard right now, so that inside might be a little weak.
Special shout out to a good friend of mine, Chris Flower, who's watching us from Laguna Beach, California this evening. Hope you're doing well, Chris.
Okay, we got a second down and 10 here at the 32-yard line with 4:46 left in this first quarter. We'll see how this injury plays out because Newport likes to play traps and they like to pull their guards. Woo, there you go.
And they had a couple big boys running out toward the boundary side of the field on that one.
There you go.
But it's going to get brought back.
Get an injury, and right away there's a false start. New guy, a little nervous, got a little antsy.
A little jumpy, it's still early.
Yeah.
Working out those early game jitters.
Here we go. It's going to be second and 15 from the 26-yard line. Tritons are up 3-0 with 4:44 left in the first quarter. Blauer under center.
Ace back. Handoff. Running to the outside.
Hassan makes back most of the penalty yardage.
4 yard gain on the play, third down and 11.
Yeah, Hassan picks up 4 yards, so it's going to be third and 11, third and long here at the ball at the 30-yard line.
See if the Triton defenders play this a little softly like they did against Modern Day whenever they got them in long yardage last week.
Shotgun formation.
It's like a cover two look for the Tritons.
Back to pass, Blauer. Oh, here comes the rush. Oh, he just got crushed. I count four guys around him.
It's like Coach Ortiz brought the house on that one. Blauer brought down by Herbert Gamboa and Julian Perry.
They look like they had a party going on back there. Fourth down and 18, ball at the 23-yard line, first quarter.
Jake Ambrose all set to punt. Christian Tober is back at the 37-yard line to return.
Oh, most got it.
Tober is dangerous. He's got a little bit of room.
Come on, Tober. Still a good pickup.
Got a good 10 yards out of it. Tritons have some great field position coming up.
It's a 4-second delay, so it's an issue. Christian Tober returns the punt, 13 yards.
Julian Perry was the one that almost got the punt block. And here comes the San Clemente offense back out on the field with really good field position right now. The ball first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Travis Wilson going under center. Looks like Chad Foster at the fullback position. Play action. Down the field. Oh!
Terrific defensive play by number 3, Landon Gillet. Looked like he was beat initially, but he had the closing speed to recover. Thought he might have had a hand on the receiver's back, but if it didn't get called, then it didn't happen, I guess.
Here we go, second and 10 at the 42-yard line. Wilson under center. Here goes a handoff, Mike Ellis-Peru. Good pickup about 5 on the...
Tackle made by Dalton Jensen.
4 yard gain on the play. Third down and 6.
Nick Pasquale and Christian Bailey.
Scoreboard shows 5, but it is 4 yards. We're looking at 3rd and 6 at the 38-yard line. Back to pass, Wilson, looking, firing. He's got him on the out. First down.
Eventually forced out by Landon Gillet.
Nick Pasquale on another reception. Good job, Nick. Pasquale picking up 13 yards on that. First and 10 at the 25-yard line. Toss right. There goes Mike.
Good pursuit from the Sailor defense.
Oh, yeah, they're swarming.
They haven't shown the Triton offense too many different looks defensively.
Got about a yard and a half on that, almost 2. Give it a second and a long 8 right now at the 24-yard line. Travis going under center. Play action, roll out. He's going to run it.
Get this. Take that guy
along,
Travis.
Oh, nice block by Graff.
Travis Wilson, the ball carrier.
One thing about these Triton receivers, they can catch, but they can also block, too.
Absolutely. Travis was eventually brought down by number 55, Ted Berry. Came all the way from the middle of the field to make a tackle out by the sideline.
Travis Wilson picks up the first down. It's going to be first and 10 at the 14-yard line. With 1:17 left in this first quarter, let's see if we can punch it in before the end of the quarter.
And finally, the Sailors decided to stack up the line of scrimmage.
I'm going double tight. Hand off to Mike Ellis-Peru. Up the middle.
Yep. Fights for a couple yards.
Mike Ellis-Peru on the carry. Number 8, Captain Steve Michelson made the tackle for the Sailors.
Pick up about 6 yards on that.
7-yard gain on the play. Football spotted at the 8-yard line of Newport Harbor. Second down and 3 yards to go.
Okay, pick up 7. Ball's marked at the 8-yard line. Got 2nd and 3. Handoff, Mike Ellis-Peru. Oh, nowhere to run there.
Right off the bat, it looked like the Triton O-line got a good push, but the Newport Harbor linebackers closed that pretty quickly. Minimal gain on the play. And we have a timeout. Nope, end of the first quarter.
End of the first quarter with the Tritons 3. Newport Harbor Sailors 0.
Pretty fast-moving quarter, Jason, and ending with maybe a closer score than a lot of us might have expected.
Oh, yeah.
But the Tritons are knocking on the door. And the Triton offense isn't really doing anything fancy. It seems like they're able to line up and run their basic offense and dare Newport Harbor to stop it. And they haven't been able to, if not for that 15-yard penalty.
Oh, yeah, they would have scored a touchdown for sure. They're just pounding the ball. They're just giving the ball to Mike Ellis-Peru, and he's running it hard.
Yep.
Like I said, they should have scored that first drive a touchdown, but the penalty cost them. They got 3. It looks like they're going to do it again and try to score a touchdown down here.
And the Sailor defense hasn't given too many different looks. It's going to be pretty easy as the game goes on for Travis Wilson and Coach Kopp to dissect that defense and find the seams.
Well, if they keep this up, they keep pounding the ball, Newport Harbor's going to have to do something to try to stop them, and you figure that's going to open them up for the throw.
Absolutely.
Down the field.
Absolutely.
Okay, we got a 3-0 score right now. Tritons are leading. Start of the second quarter. It's 3rd down and 3. Ball marked down about the 8-yard line. Second quarter here.
You wonder if the Tritons are in 4-down territory here, Jason, because even if you don't get it, you force the Sailor offense to go 90-plus yards for a score, and they haven't proven they can move the ball against us yet.
That's something to think about. And, you know, Mike's picking up 4 or 5 yards, you know, carry. Doesn't look like he's in. It looks like Nick Pasquale in the backfield right now, and they toss it to Nick, and there goes a big hole right there, and he's going to go in for the score.
Triton touchdown.
There it is. Yep, referee throws it up. Touchdown, Nick Pasquale.
Triton's ran the ball off tackle to the left behind big Kyle Murphy. Well, makes play calling easy when you got a player like that out there.
Oh, yeah. If you're going to run it, you might as well run it his way. Here we go with the extra point here. Brett Miller, the kicker. Kick is up, and it is good. So the Tritons are leading here 10-0 with 11:55 left in the second quarter. That score is brought to you by Rick Anya, Council for Education, Travel USA.
See Coach Allred down there working with the kickoff unit. Coach Allred made a living in the NFL for several years playing with the Steelers and the Bears, so great addition to the staff.
Oh, yeah.
We had him down at the freshman level, but he got bumped up to varsity during the offseason.
I know. I worked with Coach Allred his first year here in the JV's level, and he was a great addition to our level. I was really sad to see him go back to varsity.
Yeah, the man is a football encyclopedia. Made his living playing special teams, so he's definitely the authority.
Oh, yeah.
Kickoff by Brett Miller goes into the end zone for a touchback.
Touchback.
We'll see how the Sailor offense responds, being down 10-0 early.
You know, that's one thing I've seen from Sacramento these past 6 years that I've been here. They've always had great kickers.
Yeah, I worked with one of them, Austin Borchardt, a few years back. From him to Aaron Jones, they've always had a... Chris Culbertson's done a great job with the kickers over the years here.
Yeah. Here we go. Newport Harbor. Cole Blauer under center.
Tritons have to switch the defensive strength. Christian Bailey lines up.
Play action. Oh! Wow. Almost sacked. Got it away. Number 42 drops the ball.
Nico Roberti brings the pressure.
These things. Number 42, Dalton Jensen, the running back, wide open, and kind of let that one go.
Couldn't hang on.
Second and 10 from the 20-yard line.
Good escapability by the quarterback, Cole Blauer, on that one.
Yeah, I thought he was down for sure. Here we go, Blauer under center. Oh. Number four, Titus with the carry.
Tried to get to the edge, but good contain by the Triton defense.
We got no gain. It's going to be third and 10. Newport Harbor shotgun formation. Handoff. Ooh.
Great stick by number 43.
Landon Cook.
Landon Cook. Nico Roberti also in on the play.
Pickup of about two.
Sailors, I guess, content to play a ball control kind of game. Hand the ball off on a draw, third and long.
Fourth and 8 at the 22-yard line. They're getting ready to punt. Let's see if we can block this punt. Oh, pressure's on. And did he? I think he got a piece of that.
He got a piece of it because he knocked the punter down, but no flag.
Oh, who picked that up?
Actually picked up by, it looked like, Austin Baker, number 45.
45.
You know, they say that 90% of the time a team blocks a punt, 45. They're going to win that game. So hopefully that bodes well for the Tritons.
So we got a block punt by the Tritons. It's going to give them great field position right now. It's going to be first and 10 at the 29-yard line.
And that is not what Newport Harbor needed. The Tritons to be set up on the 29-yard line.
Shotgun formation for Travis Wilson. Back to pass. Oh, batted down. Tried a little quick pass to Jake Elston out there to the right, and it was batted down. It's going to be second down and 10 at the 29-yard line. Penalty marker on the field. Delay a game.
Penalty flag on the field. Officials signal a delay of game against San Clemente. 5-yard penalty, it'll be second down and 15.
So we got a second and 15 right now at the 34-yard line. Travis in shotgun formation. Fakes the handoff, throwing down the field. Oh. A
little bit of incidental contact between Jake Graff and number 34, Corey Cablay.
Corey Cablay and Titus Hassan on the coverage for the Sailors.
Looks like Titus Hassan is doing double duty, playing tailback and DB. Going to be third and 15 at the 34 for the Tritons. See where you picked up this first down.
Looks like the Sailor defense has given us something underneath.
Wilson rolling out. Oh!
Oh, and he's picked off.
Overthrown. Oh. Travis chasing him down and ran him out of bounds. Yeah, oh, they're going to call a flag on that. Are you kidding me? Wow. I think Pasquale and Wilson were just a little off on that. Wilson thought he was going to keep going, and Pasquale turned inside.
Yeah, a little bit of miscommunication between Travis and Nick Pasquale. He had Pasquale in the flat running an out pattern. Pasquale saw that Travis was in trouble, so he turned upfield for a deep route, and Travis couldn't quite get it there.
And they got a personal foul, late hit out of bounds. He must have stepped out of bounds, and Travis Wilson pushed him out.
So the Sailors survived the block punt and ended up with great field position on the Triton 46.
First and 10 at the 46 for Newport Harbor. Handoff. And he's not going to get anything.
So far, the Sailor offense cannot get anything going on the ground. Eventually, they're going to have to open up Cole Blauer to test the Triton defense and soften them up a little bit. Otherwise, it's just going to be more of the same.
Second and 10 at the 46-yard line right now. High backs. Motion handoff. Tried that weak side power.
Third and long for the Sailors.
Third and 9 at the 45-yard line with 8:48 left in the second quarter.
Last time they were in this situation, they handed the ball off, not wanting to take any risks deep in their own territory. Now that they're in midfield, let's see what they call.
Back to back. Oh!
Receiver broke inside Nick Pasquale's coverage. Quarterback threw him outside. And the Sailors will have to punt. Christian Tover heading back to field it.
Yeah, that pressure was on him.
Number 19, Jake Ambrose, back to kick for Newport Harbor. Let's see if the Tritons come after this one again. Since it's at midfield, they may play a little safe. Looks like that's what they're going to do. And boom goes the dynamite. Kicks it out of bounds. And the Tritons will start at about the 15-yard line.
You know, they didn't have pressure coming on, but it looks like they could have got to him.
Yeah, not looking good for the Harbor, Newport Harbor special teams.
Here comes Triton's offense back onto the field. It's going to be first and 10. Ball at the 20-yard line. They marked down at the 20-yard line with 8:29 left in the second quarter. Let's see if they can just keep it on rolling and truck it down the field.
I know. I
kind of
like that.
Wilson to the handoff. Nope.
Mike Ellis-Peru still on his feet.
Ellis-Peru kept his feet moving pretty well. He only got 3 yards, but he worked for every bit of that. So you did a great job on that play. It was number eight, Steve Michelson, defensively. Closed down from the strong side end position, blew up the lead block, and that's what got Ellis-Peru into trouble.
Second down and eight at the 23-yard line right now.
Trojans operating from the hash.
Travis Wilson with the toss out to Mike Ellis-Peru.
And the Sailor defense has picked it up a little bit defensively. Bring up third and about four.
Sean Manoa, Zach Wade, and the Sailor defense with the stop.
Yeah, it's going to be third down and four from the 26-yard line.
Coach Kopp is very unpredictable in these situations. Third and about four. He's got enough confidence in his running game to call something on the ground. But we'll see if he decides to let Travis air it out.
You know what? Yeah, it might be a running play. Chad Foster's in at fullback.
Maybe setting up a play action. Nope. Ellis-Peru.
Power run. There goes Mike Ellis-Peru, and he got the first down.
It's going to be very close, Jason. I bet they're going to have to measure this one.
He needed to get to the 30, and he just got over. It's about the 30 and a half right now. That's a first down.
He was brought down by number 16, Zach Wade, to the Sailors. But they are going to give him the first down.
First and 10. They mark it just close to the 31-yard line. Handoff.
Same play.
Wow. Good run.
Tritons bring the weak side guard around through the hole.
Mike Ellis-Peru on the carry.
And he followed Chad Foster up the gut. Nice gain on the play.
Yeah, right up the middle. Pick up about seven.
8 yards on the play.
Make it eight. It's going to be second down and two at the 39-yard line with 6:09 left in this second quarter. Chad Foster at fullback. We got Nick Pasquale back at the tailback position. Double tight. Pitch to Pasquale. He's going to take it outside. Oh, he's still on his feet. Knee did not touch the ground. Hand was down, but the knee did not go down.
Great balance shown by Nick Pasquale.
He picked up about 10, 11, 12 yards on that play. They're going to mark it.
Blay brings him down.
They're going to mark it just shy of the 50. I'll be touching the line.
Their offense looks really efficient so far, Jason. Other than the penalty and the ill-advised INT, they're looking pretty sharp.
Yeah, they're not letting them rest. They're ready to go. And it's a quick handoff to the fullback.
Fullback trap.
Landon Cook. Oh, late flag.
There's some yellow on the field. This one might be coming back. And yeah, it's going to be a hold against San Clemente.
Yeah, it was coming from the back, Judge. That's where usually it is. Wow, that was a good run, too. He got about 8-9 yards on that carry, and they're going to take it back. Yeah, they're keeping this Newport Harbor defense off track by getting to the line quick. They're going really quick.
10-yard penalty. First down and 20.
I don't see anything else but the Sailors can do other than start stacking the line of scrimmage to stop these running plays. Because the Tritons offense is mixing up the way they run the ball, inside, outside, toss, straight handoff.
Yeah, they're mixing up their backs. They're giving it to the fullback, and even the fullback's getting a lot of yardage. Handoff to Mike Ellis-Peru.
He gets the edge.
He's got a he got a good pickup. It was first and 20 at the 40. He picked up about, let's see where they're marking the ball at.
Got a good 9 or 10 on that.
Yeah.
Sailor defense backed off that time. Expecting pass, but they don't know Coach Kopp. He's pretty unpredictable.
So we're looking at second 11 at the 48-yard line, 49-yard line. Landon Cook at the fullback. Mike Ellis-Peru at tailback. I'm thinking pass here. Roll out. Now straight drop back. Throws to the Cook. Oh, nice catch. Had to turn around quick and get that. Held on to it. Picked up about 6 yards on that. It's going to be third and five at the 45.
Vince Aquavecchi eventually making the tackle.
Back to pass, Wilson, firing to McGrath. Oh!
Risky play by Travis Wilson.
Yeah.
Pass intended for number 3, Jacob Ralph, is incomplete.
The Triton offense is sort of in that gray area, whether to go for it or to punt. Depends on the philosophy this week, whether to go for the throat or to play a ball control type of game. It looks like the Triton offense is going to go for it on 4th and 5.
Fourth and five from the 45. Yeah, they didn't get that penalty. It's a first down. Wilson getting back in the shotgun formation. Oh, they just called flag. Delay game. I'm thinking they're going to punt it now. Wow. Another penalty costing them. So here comes punter out in the field.
Corey Cablay deep to receive at about the 15.
Alvarez kicking. And, oh, gets it away.
More flag yellow
on the field.
On the field. Tritons leave it alone. Probably a good decision.
Xavier Washing down there to jump on the ball. See what this penalty is. False start, San Clemente. So out comes Alvarez again to try another punt. They're gonna back him up by. Looked like it was the personal protector that moved.
5 yard penalty signaled against the Titans.
So now Cablay is set up at about the 20-yard line.
Fourth.
Let's see if Alvarez kicks away from him again.
Fourth and 15 at the 45. Oh, low snap. Oh!
Yeah. Not Alvarez's best kick. It looks like they're trying to kick it away from Cablay. Well, 2 punts in a row, they haven't gone near him.
It was a low snap, and number 30 for Newport Harbor got in there quick. I think he was just trying to get it away before it was blocked. It was a good job by Alvarez getting away.
22-yard punt with no return.
That'd be Andrew Williams from Newport Harbor. Here we go, 4:11 left in the second quarter. First and 10 at the 33-yard line for Newport Harbor. Blower puts a guy in motion and handoff to Titus. Nothing there. Try to go off tackle. There was nothing there for him.
Yeah, try to follow big number 7, Ramsey Valente. but Valente wasn't quite agile enough to get to the spot.
Second and 10, 34-yard line. Ball in the guard. Titus trying to go off. Ooh.
Great pursuit by the Triton defense. Jason, I'm really impressed so far with how whenever the Sailor offense adjusts to a different formation, the Triton defense is all over it, switching position, getting the Sam backer on the strong side.
Yeah, they're well coached by Coach Ortiz, doing a great job. It's going to be third and 8 at the 35-yard line right now.
They had a great week of preparation. And I'll tell you, the coaches were a little bit concerned that this could have been a trap game after the great victory last week against Modern Day, a real hard-fought contest. The coaches were worried that the players wouldn't be able to get up for this one, but so far they have on both sides of the ball. Except for a couple of miscues, it seems like the Tritons are in control of this one.
Oh, delay of game, Newport Harbor. It's about the third one today, huh? One for Newport, two on San Clemente. Two or three on San Clemente.
Yep.
So they're watching that clock really close. Here we go, third and 13 at the 30-yard line. Shotgun formation for Blauer. Hand off to Titus. Oh! Nowhere to go.
Look for a second that number 29, Nico Roberti, is going to lose contain, but he managed to get his arms wrapped around Hassan and bring him down. Again, more conservative play calling from Newport Harbor on third and long. They do not trust their quarterback to air the ball out against this Triton defense. 2.5 minutes left in the half, folks, and if the San Clemente offense executes pretty well, they could close out this half with the score, hopefully.
San Clemente calls for a timeout with 2 minutes, 30 seconds.
San Clemente calls timeout. 2:30 left in the game. It's fourth down and 13 at the 25-yard line. I'm good. Take a quick word from our sponsors here with Doug Greek from Greek's Concrete, Rick Anaya, Council for Education Travel USA, Paul from Little Page Landscaping, Mark from Little Page Automotive, Michael Merrigan from OC Tavern, Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom and Remodeling, and Aaron's family from South Coast Distributing. Here we go, getting set for the punt team.
Christian Tober deep to receive. Tritons don't bring as much pressure this time.
Short
fair
punt.
Catch signaled.
Short punt.
And he got it. It'd be Triton ball at about the 47-yard line.
You know, Mike, you were talking about Newport Harbor being safe and going with draws on third down and long. I'll tell you what, when Christian Tober was a sophomore, he had a lot of picks on that sophomore team.
They probably remember that. Afraid to go his way. But give the Sailor team credit. They've hung in there. It's a closer game than a lot of people expected. 10-0, this game is far from over at this point.
Yeah, 10-0. That's a close game. That's two scores. Oh, nice pass from Wilson.
So far, the Sailors that I have seen have not played any man coverage. They really kind of respect and fear the speed of the San Clemente skill players. They're setting up a shell and giving us whatever we want underneath.
Jake Elson with 11-yard pickup. Good catch, Jake. Another Triton first down, first and 10 at the 42-yard line. 2:24 left. Wilson in the shotgun formation. Back to pass.
Throws it short. Mike Ellis-Peru trying to make it to the outside. Puts that down. Oh, got a couple more yards.
Number three, Landon Gillet, finally made the stop, but he had to pay dearly to make it. I've seen the Sailor defense on a cover two, a cover three. Sometimes I see him in quarters, but Travis Wilson's a smart quarterback. He's going to pick that apart unless you apply some pressure. And on that play, he had all day to throw.
Here we go. Hurry up offense. First and 10. Oh, we got movement.
Might have been induced. It looked like the D-line was trying to play some games. But doesn't look like that way to the referee.
No, I seen a couple of guys from San Clemente moving. I think the center forgot to snap.
Oh, well, that'll happen.
Connor O'Brien. So Wilson will take him into the huddle. They'll break it. It's going to be first and 15 at the 31-yard line. 2:10 left. Oh, fake draw. Quarterback draw. Wilson getting more yardage. He's going down to the 5-yard line.
Great call by Coach Kopp. We haven't seen that look yet. He's been throwing out of the shotgun and doing basic handoffs and a power eye. They did not expect that from Travis Wilson at all, and it caught him by surprise.
Oh, not at all. He picked up 26 yards, and, they were looking back at the receivers. They had no clue Wilson was going to go with that ball. That's how much they respect his arm. It's going to be first and 5 at the 5-yard line, first and goal to goal. Here we go. Tritons with 3 backs in the backfield. Hand off to Mike Ellis-Peru, and he walks it in. Touchdown.
Yeah, that quarterback draw pretty much demoralized the Sailor defense, and they had their heads down. And I'm not saying the game's over by any stretch, but that's a tough one to recover from right before the half, going up 17-0 against what the Sailors know is a very good Triton team. Again, it's not over, but that's going to be a tough one to come back from.
Good job by Mike Ellis-Peru getting in the end zone. Oh.
PAT by Brett Miller is good. Minute 48 to go in the half, folks. Sailors will get the ball, and if they're going to want to, assuming the kickoff goes okay for the Triton coverage team, if Sailors want to score, they're going to have to get way more aggressive with their play calling than they've been so far.
And that score is brought to you by Little Page Landscaping. Tritons have a 17-0 lead right now, 1:48 left in the second quarter. Tell you what, the Tritons are doing a really good job right now. They just got to settle down on those penalties.
Gets away. Looks like Brett Miller got a hold of that one.
Oh, yeah, in the end zone.
Brett Miller's kickoff into the end zone for a touchback. Football spotted at the 20-yard line of the Sailors. First down and 10.
Curious to see what Coach Ortiz's defensive philosophy is here. Last week against Modern Day, he only rushed 4 guys toward the end of the game when Modern Day was making their game-tying drive. And Modern Day was able to move the ball. I'm curious to see if Coach Ortiz decides to bring some pressure this time around in a similar situation.
Let me ask you, Mike, what would you do in this situation?
Well, my team's only 2-3, so you don't ask me what I would do, but I like to bring the heat, and I like to bring pressure.
Why not?
If you have the athletes, which San Clemente clearly does.
Let's see if they can handle it. That would be a good call. Oh, there. Julian Perry with some pressure up the middle, playing nose guard.
And I understand the philosophy offensively for Newport Harbor, get the ball in the hands of your best player, which Titus Hassan. But, the Tritons are expecting this. You have to air it out. You have to open it up at this point if you expect to get a score before halftime.
It's going to be second down and 10 at the 20-yard line. Yeah, I can understand what Newport Harbor is thinking right now. They're thinking, okay, it's still a close game, 17-0. Let's take it in this way. Let's not give up a costly interception.
and, you know, give Temple many more points.
Well, you have to play to win still. You can't play not to lose.
True. But there they go. Titus Hassan. Oh!
A little bit of room that time for Hassan.
That's true. Maybe that's what they're expecting right now. Maybe, you know, you said this is one of the better backs that Tritons are facing right now. Maybe they're expecting him to break a long one down the street here.
Yeah.
Seen it happen before, so.
It's true, but you know, they say the definition of insanity is trying the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. And that's what the Sailor offense is doing at this point. But it's going to be third down and four. If I had to guess, I would say Newport Harbor runs the ball, hopefully gets a first down. But if they don't, force the Tritons to burn their last time out before punting away.
Okay, it's third down and four at the 25-yard line. Let's see what the Sailors do here. Fake handoff, play action, throwing it to the tight end. Oh, he's hit hard. But he hangs on.
Looked like Christian Tober on the hit. Great stick by Tober. Play went into the flat, and the Titans were in a cover two. Tober was sitting right on it. But it is the Sailor first down.
Complete to their tight end, number seven. First and 10 at the 32-yard line. I don't know. I think it's a little late to go to the air right now. Oh, he's got him wide open.
He got a step on
Tober.
Oh.
Wow.
I think Christian Tober has caught peeking in the backfield. Sailors made him pay. Got over the number three. Landing Goulet got over the top of Christian Tober on that one. I don't know if Tober had deep third himself or if he was expecting safety help over the top. But in any case, Goulet made a nice play for the Sailor offense. Their best of the day by far, Jason.
Oh, yeah, that was a great job by Tober catching him because he could have been off to the races.
Absolutely.
Timeout signaled on the field by Newport Harbor.
It's going to be first and 10 at the 29-yard line. That was great pickup for Newport Harbor right there.
Exactly what they needed. 30 seconds left. They have two timeouts left. They're in good position here if they can sustain it a little bit.
Congratulations goes out to the girls.
Right now, they're looking, what, about a 46-yard field goal?
They're in action next to
about that.
Take a quick break for our sponsors here. Doug Greek from Greek's Concrete. Rick Anaya, Council for Educational Travel USA. Paul from Little Page Landscaping. Mark from Little Page Automotive. Michael Merrigan from OC Tavern. Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom and Remodeling. The Aarons family from South Coast Distributing. And here we go.
And the good news is the halftime food just arrived.
Cole Blauer under center. Play action. Looking.
Nope.
They go right back to Landon Goulet.
Now they're leaving Goulet some room to operate out there.
They're giving him that little cushion, yeah.
Pushed out of bounds by Christian Tober.
And that's going to be a first down, first and 10 at the 16. You're looking now about a 33-yard field goal. So they're not too sure about the Sailors kicker, but that seems pretty reasonable for a varsity kicker, 33 yards.
I would think so. But I think they've got a couple shots left before they come to that.
24 seconds left in this half. Let's see if the Triton defense can come up with the turnover.
Looks like the Tritons are in man coverage. Means they're blitzing.
Throws outside. Oh, you got to turn around. Oh, no.
Like I said, the Tritons blitzed. They left the corner one-on-one against. against the Harbor receiver, Nick Pasquale couldn't hang on. The pressure did get to Cole Blower. They put a nice hit on him, but and excellent at, pattern run by
look
the
Look at
the
throw
receiver.
To Landon Goulet.
Goulet, yeah, Goulet has been their stud on this drive.
That's their guy.
Three big plays for him. He got past Nick Pasquale, who's usually a lockdown defender.
Coach Ortiz has got to be furious with that. 18 seconds left. Oh, he's coming off the edge.
Forced Tober. A wide PAT. Good job by Christian Tober. Redeeming himself a little bit on that one. And the Tritons hang on to an 11-point lead.
17-6. Tritons up 17-6, 18 seconds before the half.
Your San Clemente Titans
17. Let's say hey to defensive line coach Casey McIntosh. How you doing out there, Casey?
Tober and Elsperu deep to receive for the Tritons. Yeah. Number 27, Christian Ochoa is kicking away from the left hash.
I tell you, when you got Tober and Mike Elsperu back there, oh, but it's short. Gonna say anything can happen.
Recovered by Austin, caught by Austin Baker at about the 20. I couldn't tell if that was an intentional pooch or if they were just afraid to get the ball to Tober or Elsperu. In any case, Austin Baker returns to the 34. Now the Tritons have 13 seconds and two timeouts. If Coach Kopp wants to be aggressive, he can run a couple plays and try to get into field goal range. We'll see what he tries to do here.
With an arm like Travis Wilson, I think maybe you take a shot.
Based on what I've seen philosophically from the Sailor defense, they're going to play really soft, give up whatever they want underneath, so we'll see what happens.
Maybe you try that quarterback draw again. Back to pass Wilson.
Four deep for the Sailors.
And he's looking, jumps it off to Mike Elsperu, and he can't get to the sidelines. They got one timeout, 1 second. No, they let a clock run down.
And that's the half, folks.
That is the final play of the first half. First half score, Sailors 6, your San Clemente Tritons 17.
Okay, so that's going to be the half. It's Tritons 17, Sailors 6. So we'll be back here in about 15 minutes, folks.
And we're back for the second half, folks. Brett Miller's lining up to kick at the 40-yard line to the Sailors. Deep to receive. Our number four, Titus Hassan. And number 34, Corey Cablay. Well played first half by the Tritons. A couple mistakes got them into trouble, but they are in control at this point. It's going to be taken by Hassan at the one. He goes up to the right sideline, finds a seam.
Getting to the outside. Oh, there he goes. Down the sideline to the 40, to the 35, to the 32-yard line. Huge, huge run back.
Nice return by Titus Hassan. Clearly the Sailor's most dangerous weapon. And he hurt the Tritons on that one. Eventually brought down by the kicker, number two, Brett Miller.
Pasquale was out there on the end, and he's got contained. He let him get outside.
And that speaks to Hassan's speed, because Pasquale is one of the fastest players the Tritons have.
Yes, he is.
And Hassan didn't have much problem getting around him, did he?
No, not at all. I think the Tritons are very lucky he didn't get it all the way to the score touchdown. Here we go, first and 10 at the 33-yard line. Motion. Play action, rolling out. No one there. He's looking down the field, and throws it to the tight end.
Complete to number seven, Vince Aquavecchi. Aquavecchi, rather. Eventually hit and brought down by number 54, Sam Hunter.
About 12 yards on that. Yeah, 12 yards. It'll be first and 10 at the 21-yard line. Not a good way to open up this second half for the Tritons. There they go. Handoff. Good pressure. And they got him in the backfield.
Great pursuit by the Triton defense. 45, Austin Baker. Kept the edge. Prevented anything big from busting out.
You know, Julian Berry was the first one back there, and he was asking for a flag. That center took him down, but no flag. It's going to be second down and 11 at the 22-yard line. Newport Harbor with the ball. Blauer under center. High formation. Fake handoff. Throwing deep. Oh, and he got it.
Great grab by number three,
again.
Landon Guillet. Christian Tober had pretty good coverage. He was underneath a little bit. They both went up for the ball, and looks like Guillet just out-jumped him for it. And don't look now, folks, but we have a tight ball game. Let's see if down five at this point, the Sailors like to go for one or two. It is early to go for two, but it just depends on the coach's philosophy, Jason.
And they're going to go for two.
It looks that way. Problem is, if you don't get it, you're chasing that missed point all game long.
If they get it, they'll be down by three. If they would have went the extra point, they would have been down by four. So,
but they're betting they have the Triton defense on its heels.
They figure
ride that momentum.
Yeah. There they go. They put the fullback in motion. They're going to roll out to the right. Throws it. And, oh, incomplete.
Pass broken up by number 10, Nick Pasquale. Great job by Nick.
Good coverage. Very good coverage.
Tritons, so they have a 5-point lead at this point.
And they tried for Goulet again. No. It looked like it was number 42, their fullback.
Couldn't ask for a much better start if you're the Newport Harbor Sailors. Great return, great kick return up to the 40-yard line. And you can see immediately the Sailors are mixing up their play calling much better than they did in the second half. They started with a quarterback rollout. They don't want Blauer to be in the pocket as a sitting duck. And then they did a nice job executing the play action for the score. The play calling in the first half was a little too predictable, and I think they're turning the page from that.
Yeah, I think they went in and made some adjustments, and Yeah, you saw a couple of bootlegs.
So number 27, Christian Ochoa will receive, or I'm sorry, lined up to kick.
Tober and Mike Ellis-Peru back to receive, and it's going to be Tober.
Short kick, fielded at the 11.
Taking it upfield, and here he goes.
Tober has a nice return of his own.
Oh, late hit. Where's the flag? No call on that. First and 10 at the 36-yard line. Tritons have the ball. Let's see what they can do. Split backs. Travis Wilson under center. Hands it off to Mike Ellis-Peru. He's going to take it off to the left side. Nope. Puts his head down. Got a few yards.
Tritons tried to get to the perimeter. Great job by number 16, Zach Wade, of cutting that off.
Pick up about three on that. It's going to be second down and seven. We're at the 39-yard line. I-backs, Chad Foster in at fullback. Handoff, Mike Ellis-Peru, and he's going to take it off to the left.
Mike Ellis-Peru, the ball carrier.
Brought down by number eight, Steve Michelson of the Sailors.
Pick up about five. We're looking at third and two, maybe three.
Third down and two.
It's a long two right now at the 44. Nope. Jump offsides.
And it'll be a free first down for the Tritons. Great job using the hard count by Travis.
You got two. Got it. Two guys from Newport Harbor jumping on that.
Offside is the signal against Newport Harbor. 5-yard penalty. Football spotted at the 49-yard line of the Tritons. And a Triton first down.
That'll be first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Split backs, Travis Wilson under center. Back to pass. Looking, throws it to Mike Ellis-Peru out to the outside.
Travis Wilson's pass is complete to number 27, Mike Ellis-Peru.
Pick up about 6 yards. It's going to be second and about four.
Eventually pushed out of bounds by Landon Guillet. Newport's been giving him the flat, giving the Tritons the flat fairly often. Travis is exploiting it so far.
They marked it back another yard, so it's going to be second and five. Handoff, Mike Ellis-Peru, he's taking it outside. Takes the corner.
Mike Ellis-Peru, the ball carrier.
10-yard pickup.
Brought down by number 34, Corey Cablay. But not before a Triton first down.
Make it an 11-yard pickup. It's going to be first and 10 at the 35-yard line.
35-yard line of the Sailors. 11-yard gain on the play and another Triton. First down.
Here we go, Triton split backs. Back to pass to Travis Wilson. Nice catch. Christian Bailey.
And I'll tell you what, Jason, the longer Newport Harbor stays in that 4-4 cover three, the longer that flat's going to be open. And unless they adjust, the Triton offense is going to be able to exploit that all the way down the field. That's two or three plays on this drive alone that our guys have been open in the flat.
Yeah, they're doing a very good job moving the ball down the field right now. They're in an eye back right now. Ball's at the, 21-yard line? First and 10. Oh!
And Chris French jumped. Hard count backfired on us that time. Back them up 5 yards. Still first down for the Tritons.
Another flag. God, has there been a series yet that we haven't had a flag, delay a game,
false start? I don't think so, Jason. A lot of miscues.
First and 15, the 26-yard line. Handoff, Mike Ellis-Peru breaking it off to the right, cutting back inside.
Mike Ellis-Peru on the carry. Titus Hassan with the tackle.
Special shout-out to Doug Dill, one of my colleagues down at the freshman level. He's doing a great job with those young guys, molding them into young men. He was born to be a head coach of the freshman team. I'll tell you what, Jason.
Doug's a good guy.
Excellent administrative skills, all that good stuff.
Played quarterback here for the Tritons.
Yes, certainly
back
did.
In the late 80s. There goes Mike Ellis-Peru, breaking it off tackle down to the 5-yard line. I got to mark it down at the 6. First and goal for the Tritons at the 6-yard line. Tritons with three backs in the backfield, giving it to Mike Ellis-Peru. Oh, ball loosed. And the Sailors say they have it. Let's see what the referees
Sailors
say.
Think they have it. The referees
agree. Wow.
I couldn't make out quite who coughed that, who caused that fumble, but another miscue for the Tritons in what could easily be a runaway game. The Tritons are allowing the Newport Harbor Sailors to hang in there.
Again, another mistake. They were moving the ball down the field with ease. And they cough it up at the 4-yard line. It's going to be first and 10 for the Sailors.
Newport Harbor's coaches must have pushed the right buttons because this looks like a different team coming out to play in the second half.
Titus on the carry. Ooh.
Nice push by the Sailor O-line there.
Titus Hassan picks up about a yard. Second and 9. Second and 9 from about the 6-yard line. Handoff to Titus Hassan. Oh, he's trying to go outside. Be third and about 3 right now. Long 3.
Big play for the Triton defense. Try to recapture some of that momentum that they lost.
Hand off to Titus. Oh, nice play.
Fortunate play for the Triton defense because their entire defensive line was slanting toward the boundary hard. And Newport Harbor went to the field side, but luckily we were able to make a play.
Got Nico Roberti again on the stop. 2 plays in a row. Good job, Nico. If they caught, nope. On a hop. Oh, yeah, it was scary. Whoa.
Christian Tober is fearless.
Christian Tober tackled by number 34, Corey Blay. Football spotted at the 50 yard line. First down at 10, St. Clemente.
No way, we got a break here. Let's give a shout out to our sponsors, Doug Greek from Greece Concrete. We We got Paul Littlepage from Littlepage Landscaping, Mark from Littlepage Automotive, Rick Anaya from Council for Education Travel USA. Tritons are under center. Handoff, Mike Ellis-Peru. There he goes. Nice gain.
And I'll tell you what, the Sailor defenders were so concerned about Ellis-Peru getting to the edge. All it took was one little outside quick step, and he was back, and his cutback lane was wide open there. Really got the Sailor defenders to over-pursue.
Sean Harlow a little slow getting up, but he's up and in the huddle. That's good confidence in the coaches, giving the ball back to Mike Ellis-Peru after that fumble. There they go. They're trying to catch Sailors off guard.
Pasquale gets the toss this time.
Pitch. Outside, cuts it back inside. Ooh,
and
another
more,
flag.
More fabric on the field.
Personal foul.
Against the Tritons.
Wow.
I hope it's not on Sean Harlow, because if it is, that might be two.
I don't know. He got up slow before, and he's limping around right now. They're marking off 15 yards right here. Let me finish giving out those shout-out to our sponsors. Michael Merrigan, Brosi Tavern, Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom and Remodeling, and the Aarons family from South Coast Distributing. It's going to be first, and what are we looking about
here? Hold on, first and about 26, looks like.
Wow.
Let's see what Coach Kopp has in the playbook for this. Not too many plays designed to get you 26 yards.
Yeah, that's about 27, yeah. Ball's at the 44-yard line, first down, so little piece at a time. Wilson, oh, dropped
it. Drop pass by number six, Marcus Meredith. Trent offense just doesn't look as sharp as it normally does, Jason. A lot of miscues along the way.
Yeah, we got a second and about 26, 27 yards. I don't know. How about a draw or screen here? Try to get some of it back. Roll out. Oh.
Inside handoff to 10, Pasquale. Now there he's
goes.
Got some
room. Oh, yeah. Coming
nice
out the
block
outside.
By number
77. He's still going. He's still on the sideline. Oh, he stepped out of bounds.
I don't think he quite
made
the
first
down.
He's still going, but I think, yeah, he's out.
He stepped out. I heard the whistle. He didn't quite get to the first down, but a
big
monster block by big 7'7", Sean Harlow. We used to call that a decleater in my day. And number seven, the victim of that, Vince Aquaveke, has his helmet off. He looks a little dinged up. Great play design by Troy Kopp.
Very nice. So now we're, instead of third and long, we're looking at third and nine. I like the third and nine better than third and 25.
Absolutely.
Back to pass Wilson, looking for, oh, no. Picked off.
And ball is intercepted by, far away. It looks like number 34.
Intended for Graff.
Corey Cablay. Not Travis's best night thus far.
It was intended for Jacob Graff. Looks like he came inside, and Wilson was looking for him to go outside.
Well, really an ill-advised throw, in my opinion. The corner was sitting right over the top. He had a good five-yard cushion, and
nope.
There was just
and there's another flag. There's another flag.
And the Tritons are
the
backing up.
And I'm guessing somebody said something in that huddle because it was the ref that was standing right over the ball.
Yeah, it looked that way to me, too. The Tritons better get their composure back.
Personal foul.
Unsportsmanlike conduct is the penalty signaled against the Tritons.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. So, yeah, something was said in the huddle or something. The ref heard it, threw the flag.
Easily the Tritons' most frustrating game of the year so far, Jason. And I don't mean that to be critical, but you start the season with three blowout victories and then a tough, hard-fought game against Modern Day last week. And now you're allowing a, you know, arguably a mid-level team in Newport Harbor to hang around and be only 5 points up in the third quarter. Like we said before, the coaches are worried about this being a trap game, and some of the Triton players just aren't dialed in enough at this point. Hopefully they can turn it around.
Yeah, with only a five-point lead right now, that's not sitting good. And they had the opportunities. They've been driving the ball, you know, and again, it's those little mental mistakes.
Absolutely, they add up.
So the Sailors got the ball, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Handoff.
Triton swarmed that pretty well. Triton defenses have always done a good job of getting 11 halves to the football. Credit to Coach Ortiz for an attacking style of play.
It's going to be a pickup of two. It's going to be second down and 8 at the 22-yard line. Again, the Tritons are up by 5, 17-12.
We haven't seen Cole Blauer test the middle of the Triton defense very often. He's thrown to the outside more often than not. Interesting to see if they stick with that game plan.
Oh. Ed, quick slant.
Yeah, on cue, quick slant. Should be good for the first down.
You know, and it looked like he had a little trouble with a handoff, or I mean from the center exchange, but he got it really quick and threw it. Well, that's a pickup of 11 yards. It's going to be a first down at the 33-yard line.
Trent didn't have a defender underneath that slant. Eventually brought down by Marcus Meredith, the safety.
Blauer under center. Ace back. Handoff to Titus out going outside. Titus Hassan with about 4 yards on that.
At this point, it's pretty obvious what the Sailors are trying to do, Jason. They don't trust their ability to run it up the gut against the Triton defense, so they're really working the perimeter, both passing and running the ball, and it's working for them with a little bit of success.
Yeah, they're trying to use Titus Hassan's speed to get it to the outside, and Triton's better watch it because he's got some speed.
Absolutely.
Going to be second about 6 right now. The ball is resting at the 37-yard line.
They're really challenging the Triton corners, Pasquale and Tober, and those kids have made some plays, but they've given some up too. Hopefully they can dial it in to close out this game.
Timeout is called by the Sailors. So we're looking at 2nd and 5. Ball's resting at the 37-yard line. Tritons are up 17-12. There's 2:25 left in this third quarter. I'll give a quick shout out to our sponsors, Doug Greek at Greek's Concrete. We got Rick Anaya, Council for Education, Educational Travel USA. Paul, Little Page Landscaping. Mark, Little Page Automotive. Michael Merrigan from OC Tavern. We got Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom and Remodeling. The Aarons family, South Coast Distributing. Looks like Marcus Meredith was getting the last minute instructions from Coach Ortiz out there. Here come the Sailors, split back, shotgun formation. Comes in motion, we got trips out to the right. Quick little bubble pass out there. Oh,
nope.
Missed tackle, two missed tackles.
Nick Pasquale did a fantastic job avoiding the block. He had a wide open lane to make the tackle, he just couldn't quite hang on.
Is that number 3 again, Landon Goulet?
That yeah, was it. Looks, it looks like yeah. It looks like Goulet is limping off the field. Doesn't look too serious. He'll probably just take a play or two.
They got a first and 10 here at the 47-yard line. Shotgun formation. Trying to roll out. Oh!
And that's dangerous.
Throws it up. Oh, almost picked off.
Number 20, Herbert Gamboa really applied the pressure and put a good hit on the quarterback, Cole Blauer. Ill-advised decision to throw that by Cole Blauer because that could have easily been picked off by a Triton defender.
And Gamboa is a player.
Coach Ortiz dialed up the blitz. It worked out for him. And this is where the Sailor offense does not want to be. Second and long, third and long. They want to get positive yards on first play.
There's a bubble screen again. Number 10. Oh, drops the ball, but that's backwards.
Pick it up.
Go. Oh, nope.
Jason just revealed his bias, but that's okay. We're all Tritons up here.
I don't know. That looked like it was behind.
Crowd's getting alive now.
Third and 10.
Big play for the Triton defense and the Harbor offense for that matter.
Back to pass. Herb Gamboa!
And there's the pressure.
Whoa.
Great series by number 20, Herbert Gamboa. Forced the incomplete pass on first down and finally brought Cole Blauer down on a big third down play for the Triton defense. And it seems that the momentum is slowly starting to shift back towards San Clemente with about a minute 45 to go in the third. See if the offense can capitalize.
Punt team on the field for the Sailors. Fourth down and 15.
Oh. Fair catch signaled for, ooh. It's like Christian Tober misjudged that. He had to catch it above his head, but pretty sure-handed kid.
Here we go, Triton's back under center, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Wilson, handoff to Mike Ellis-Peru.
He sidestepped one defender but was stuck by another. It looks like that was number four, Tyler Hassan. Titus Hassan, my bad. And,
oh. Triton down.
Ellis Peru having a tough time getting up. Training staff gets out there pretty quickly. We'll see what's wrong with him.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you direct your attention to the scoreboard at the western end of the stadium, the winning ticket number for tonight's 50-50 drawing is $705 in cash.
We're looking at a second and 8 here at the 22-yard line. 57 seconds left in this third quarter. The Tritons are up 17-12. It's a close game here. And Mike's up.
Walking a little gingerly, favoring his left knee a little bit.
Yeah, I seen him grab it right now.
But it looks like it's nothing serious. I think he'll be all right. Nick Pasquale in the backfield now.
Pasquale and Cook in the backfield. It's going to be second down and 8.
Hey, next time I'll just give you my ticket to $100 and just read the number.
And a flea flicker. down the field. He's got Tober, and he catches it down to the 30, 28-yard line. See where the ref marks it, 30-yard line. Huge.
Number 21, Derek Kula, the junior, was on the coverage. I don't think he was fooled necessarily. Just a matter of great speed against not-so-great speed. Christian Tober got over the top of him. Gutsy play call by Coach Kopp.
Caught him off guard. Yeah, that was a very good play. Oh, got a pitch out to Nick Pasquale. He's cutting it back inside. Give him a stiff arm. Pickup of about 10.
Number 16, Zach Wade in on the stop.
Squally started out to the right side, cut it back to the left. We got a first and 10 at the 20. 21 seconds left in this third quarter. It looks like they're going to try to run a play. Split backs. Gives it to Nick. Trying to cut outside.
You know, people assume with the two backs, Elsbrew, the bigger guy, and Pasquale, the smaller guy, they assume that Nick Pasquale is more of a scat back, but he can run with some power, boy, I tell you.
Oh, yeah, he's got some speed.
Pasquale's hobbling a little bit, trying to run it off.
Pick up about 8.
And that will be the third quarter. Didn't start out the way the Tritons wanted, but they seem to have taken a little bit of the control back. But I don't think they'll be satisfied with anything less than a touchdown here, Jason.
Oh, I think they need to get a touchdown here. Field goal will give them an 8-point lead. That gives Newport Harbor a chance to score with a 2-point conversion. So I think they need a touchdown here. Okay, so we'll be coming down in the fourth quarter, and it's second down and 2. Ball at the 12-yard line. 17-12, Tritons. Let's give a word to our sponsors here. Doug Greek of Greek's Concrete. Rick Anaya from Council for Educational Travel USA. Paul for Little Page Landscaping. Mark for Little Page Automotive. Michael Merrigan for OC Tavern. We got Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom and Remodeling. The Aarons family for South Coast Distributing. Okay, second down and 2 with the ball to 12. We got 3 backs in the backfield. Handoff. Nick Pasquale. And he's got a first down.
Ted Berry in the stop. He gets up pretty slowly. I think the Triton ground attack is starting to wear down the Sailor defense.
I was thinking the same thing. That's like the third guy I seen get up slowly in this drive.
Full house backfield for the Tritons. Toss to Pasquale. Sailor defense wraps him up after about a 2 or 3 yard gain, but San Clemente's knocking on the door.
Second and 3, the ball at the 3-yard line. Second and goal to goal. Hand off to Pasquale, and he jumps over, and I think he's in.
Great play by Nick Pasquale, over the top.
Touchdown, San Clemente, 23-12 with 11:07.
Big drive by the Triton offense, Jason.
They got to feel really good about that drive. And what set them up was that flea flicker.
Absolutely, absolutely. Gutsy play. And Brett Miller gives the Tritons a 12-point lead, 24-12. 11 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Provide for Brett Miller is good. 11 minutes.
And that score is brought to you by Mark Little Page for Little Page Automotive. So here we go with 11:07 left in the game. The Tritons got a 12-point lead, 24-12.
Tritons lining up to kick off. It's going to be Corey Cablay and Titus Sasson deep to return. They're hoping Brett Miller doesn't put it in the end zone because I'm sure they want to get another opportunity for a big run back.
And it's a low drive.
Kick by Miller. Fielded by Cablay.
Here comes Tober. Oh,
and he didn't have much help from his blockers because the Tritons swarm him up, wrap him up at about the 14-yard line. Not a great return scheme by the Newport Harbor Sailors.
Yeah, they got it back to the 14-yard line.
Looked like they were trying to set up a return along the right sideline, but Brett Miller either guessed or Tritons had a good sense of what they were trying to do because he kicked it off to the right. Stretched him out too far to set up that sideline return.
Here we go, first and 10 at the 14-yard line. 11 minutes left. Handoff. Oh, nice play.
Unblocked off the edge, number 44,
Julian Perry. You know, Julian Perry used to play inside backer when he was a sophomore, and we had played a little bit of nose, and I think they like him down there in that D line.
And more of what the Sailors do not want offensively, negative yardage on first play, on first down, rather. They're going to have to use Blauer and get him out of the pocket if they want him. They want to recover from that first down play because he has not been that effective inside the pocket thus far.
Play action, looking deep, throws it, got a man. Oh, nice play.
Yeah, you know, they went for number three, landing
Goulet
right up the seam, and he was never really open.
Limping off the field again.
Yep, a little banged up.
He's been their go-to guy all game, but he got hurt that one series.
Yep, and he might have had a step on the corner, Nick Pasquale, but the safety, they were in a cover three, Christian Bailey, and he ran it right up the seam. There was no way Christian Bailey wasn't going to get to that football. Good job disguising the coverages by the San Clemente DBs.
Back to pass, looking, he's going to roll out. Oh, he's got a hand on him. Oh, Harlow just jumps on his back. Blauer giving the piggyback right to Harlow.
Yeah, it's not going to last too long.
I would say not.
If you got Sean Harlow on your back, you're not going to be running very far.
It's going to be fourth down and nine, ball at the 16-yard line, and the Sailors are in to punt.
The fearless Christian Tober back to return at about the 49. Oh, he's going to have some room to run this one back.
Nice punt.
Takes Tober all the way back to the 34. Cuts up inside.
And he's coming to the outside. Oh!
And he's brought down by number 43, who is not listed on the roster.
Got it to about the 47-yard line.
I think his name's Jim.
It's going to be first and 10 right now for the Tritons at the 48-yard line. They're in control right now. They're in split backs. Back to pass, Travis Wilson. Throwing it out to Bailey. Bailey doing a couple of moves out there, and he gets a first down. Pass is complete to 12-yard pickup.
Steve Michelson finally brings him down, but he was able to juke a couple of guys. You can tell that the Sailor defenders' legs are getting tired. They can't recover quickly from those kinds of juke steps.
And the Tritons hurrying back up to the line, trying to get this playoff, keep them on their toes. Hand off to the fullback. Landon Cook with a very good run. About 15 yards on that.
Landon was brought down by number 16, Zach Wade. Backside handoff to the fullback. Caught the Sailors off guard.
Julian Perry going into the huddle. It looks like he's going to take over at fullback. First and 10 for the Tritons at the 25.
Joey Bonfugulo in the game now for the Tritons. He gets the
Joey
toss.
Taking the toss. Trying to cut outside. Cuts back in. Nice pickup. 5 yards. Second and 4. Ball on the 19-yard line. 8:13 left in this game. Handoff to Nick Pasquale, taking it to the outside. Looks like he's going to be shorter for first down.
Nick Pasquale on the carry.
Nick was brought down by number 7, Vince Aquavecchi.
Say it's third and a long one, almost 2. Hand off to Nick Pasquale, picks, and he's got it.
Good second effort there by Nick Pasquale. Sailors had him wrapped up, but he was able to fight for an extra couple of yards.
First and 10, Triton.
Seven and a half minutes to go in this one, and the Sailor defense really needs to find a way to get the ball back and keep the Tritons from scoring. Even a field goal would be pretty devastating to the Sailors' hopes in this one.
Toss to Joey. Nope, he's still running. I didn't hear a whistle. Now they're saying, oh, whoa.
Sailors have a player down.
Little scuffle down there. See one Sailor without his helmet on.
That's number 16, Zach Wade.
I don't blame Joey for keep running. I didn't hear a whistle.
Sure, absolutely. That's what they're coached to do from day one. Play until you hear that whistle.
It'll be second and 10 from the 14-yard line. Wilson hands it off to Nick Pasquale. Oh, the ball pops up and...
And looks like it's recovered by number 8, Steve Michelson.
Oh, wow.
Sailor captain comes up with a big play for the Sailors. That's exactly what they needed if they wanted to have a hope of staying in this one.
You know, he just had a good hit on him, and he just popped it right out and popped it straight in the air.
To me, it didn't look like Nick ever really had a firm grip of the ball. It might have been a handoff exchange problem. In any case, it's the Sailor ball at about the 15-yard line.
You know, looking to my left here, I can see the screen from Cox 3, and he had a handle of the ball. He got turned around and popped out. Thank you, Cox 3, for having the screen to my left. Wish I would have seen that earlier. Anyway, we're in a timeout here. We'll give a word out to our sponsors. Say thanks for Doug Greek and Greek's Concrete, Rick Anaya, Council for Educational Travel USA, Paul, Little Page Landscaping, Mark from Little Page Automotive, Michael Merrigan, OC Tavern, Reno and Greg from Rocco's Custom Remodeling, Aaron's family, South Coast Distributing. Here we go, the Newport Harbor Sailors under center, first and 10 at the 15-yard line.
Titus Hassan on the fly sweep. The Trojans cut off the perimeter. He's forced to cut back, and the Trojan defense was all over it. I wonder if the Sailors are trying to set up a sort of a swing double pass kind of play.
I don't know.
They're going to need to pull out the stops if they're going to want to. They got to move the ball 85-some yards just to score.
That play looked really slow on happening there.
You know, slow to develop, and time is definitely not on the Sailors' side at this point. 6 minutes to go, halfway through the fourth quarter. The Sailors need to score twice.
Yeah, I think they would need to take some shots down the field because, yeah, they got to score twice here. Here we go. Shotgun. Look, he's running, scrambling.
He's a good athlete.
Chased out of bounds. Looks like number 29, Nico Roberto.
Yeah, it's going to be third and short for the Sailors. You got to think at this point in the game they're in four down territory. Even though they're backed up, not backed up, but they're on their own 23-yard line, they have to score twice, and they only have 5 minutes and change to do it. So they're going to have two chances to get a couple of yards here.
Third and two for the Sailors to see what they try to do here. Handoff.
It's going to be very close. I'm not sure he got it.
See where the referee marks the ball. Who carried that? Number 24.
AJ Sweese, ball carrier. You're wondering on such a critical play, why isn't the ball in Titus Hassan's hands?
Yeah, he's been running the ball all night. Where is he at?
Fourth and inches for the Sailor offense. They didn't quite get it. And like I said, they have to go for it here.
I think you're going to have to watch out for that quarterback sneak.
Absolutely. They've loaded up the center right there.
There he goes. And he tries to push him in. And let's see.
It looked like he might have gotten the push.
Yeah.
The spot looks
according
like
to
he
the marks,
probably
yeah.
got it. Yep. Referee standing on about the 26. I don't think they're even going to need to measure this one. Referee standing on the 26, I'm sorry.
You know, after they tried that fly sweep, I haven't seen Titus anywhere. Do you see him?
No, I don't, Jason. Good point.
First and 10 for the Sailors at the 26-yard line. High back formation. Flower looking deep, throwing.
Once again, the flat is open.
Oh.
They might get Nick Pasquale for a late hit. That's pretty chintzy. He didn't.
Another flag goes.
Uh-oh. These boys better keep their composure.
We know the first one's going to be a push out of bounds, so they're going to call a late hit on that. And let's see what this second one is.
Julian Perry is fired up. It looks like the second flag might have been on him, and he clearly disagrees with the call. I disagree with the call on the far sideline of Nick Pasquale. He didn't hit the guy very hard. Coach Hamrow is getting in the face of Julian Perry. Doing his best to calm the young man down.
Yeah, personal foul on Julian Perry.
Now, Newport Harbor is still running play action. It's clear they can't run the ball at this stage in the game. There's just not enough time left for them to do it. So hopefully the Triton linebackers aren't getting sucked in. In any event, give the Sailor offense 15 extra yards.
Wow, you don't want to do that. Look at the runoff.
Oh, make that
wow,
30 yards.
30 yards.
Two personal fouls.
They got the hit out of bounds and then unsportsmanlike conduct, and that's huge.
Absolutely.
With 4:29 left in this game.
If there's one thing you didn't want to do, it's give 30 free yards to the Sailor offense.
Making it too easy for them. Again, mental mistakes here.
Yep.
That's one thing you try to push these players. Don't make mental mistakes, and two of them, one play. Personal foul and an unsportsmanlike conduct.
Can you guys throw a couple more flags? You can get them down to three here.
First and 10 for the Sailors at the 32-yard line. And they're making it very easy right now for these Sailors.
We'll see how the Triton defense responds.
Shotgun formation.
Motion out to
back
Trips.
Coming out. Motion. Screen. Both sides. Oh, nice play.
They tried to flood the wide side with a fake screen and then run the actual screen back on the boundary side. But
yeah, they went back to
Landon Cook wasn't having any of that. He sniffed that one out pretty nicely.
Titus is back in, and that's who they threw it to. Wow, yeah, what? Oh, they must have called that incomplete because they put it back at the line of scrimmage.
Yep, clock's not moving. 4:21 to go in the fourth quarter. Triton's up by 12, but the Sailors making a move here.
Second and 10, I formation. Play action. He's looking, and pressure's on. He throws it, and he throws it out of bounds.
Out of bounds. They tried to run a little out and go on the far side, but Triton's had double coverage. One guy underneath, one guy over the top. Flower wisely threw it out of bounds.
Kyle Murphy with the pressure for the Titan defense.
See some signs down here from the fans get loud. But I don't hear this Triton sideline getting loud right now.
Well, they're ignoring the,
here they go.
The kids with the signs. But
make some noise, get loud. Now they're starting to come alive. Third and 10, ball at the 32-yard line. Shotgun formation. Oh, false start on the Sailors. I think it was a little delayed snap from the center.
While you have the chance, ladies and gentlemen, get down to the Titan Touchdown Grill. They've got teriyaki meat for chicken bowls up.
Julian Perry still on the sideline with his helmet down.
So after committing two unwise personal fouls, the Tritons have been able to put the Sailor offense in a hole. Third down and 15, the 37-yard line. Let's see what Coach Ortiz elects to do here. Looks like he's going to bring the house.
There it is.
And he's got him. He's all over the quarterback, Blauer. That was number 43, Landon Cook, unblocked up the gut.
Lost about 13
and
yards.
Like a base slam blitz.
Oh, they only gave him about five, and he pushed him back to the 50.
And it looks like the Newport Harbor team is going to punt. I don't understand this, Jason. There's under 4 minutes to go. I understand it's fourth and long, but you have to give it a chance.
Yeah, you do. I don't understand it either.
Even if you do get the ball back, you're just not going to have enough time. You've got to score two times.
Especially.
I just don't understand this decision. Far be it from me to second guess a respected coach and Jeff Brinkley, but I do not get why you punt with 3.5 minutes to go, down 12.
And here's the thing, Mike, is the Tritons have been shooting themselves in the foot with penalties. They've been moving the ball, though, you know, so
absolutely.
I expect them to wear out the clock
absolutely.
Right now.
You look at the 30 yards and penalties on that drive as a gift. You're lucky to be on the 40-yard line. You've got to pull out of the stops and try to get that first down, in my opinion.
I don't think the Tritons had a three and out yet, have they?
No, I don't believe so, Jason. Good point. No, look for a heavy dose of run here from the Tritons.
Well, you got Chad Foster in at fullback, so.
And the Sailors only have one timeout remaining, which does not work in their favor.
That's nice run.
Number six, Marcus Meredith. Going to be close to the first down. More importantly for the Tritons, he stays in bounds.
We got a Sailor down right now.
Looks like number two, Stone Manoa, who's made some nice plays tonight for the Sailor defense. But
and,
he looks pain right there.
Oh, whoa. We got a referee yelling at Harlow over here. Harlow's throwing up his hands like, you know, I didn't say anything. But referees. Talking to Coach Hamron, he's looked like he's giving a mirrorful over there.
Number two on their
You know, I know he's hurt, but he took off that helmet and he threw it sky high.
Yeah. What a frustration being vented.
So with 3:16 left in the game, it's going to be a second down and one, ball at the 32-yard line. 24-12, Tritons. Tell you what, with a first down right here, they might lock this game up. Giving a shout out to our sponsors. We got Doug Greek from Greek's Concrete. Rick Anaya, Council for Educational Travel USA. Paul, Little Page Landscaping. Mark of Little Page Automotive. Michael Merrigan from the OC Tavern. Reno and Greg from Rocco Custom and Remodeling. Aaron's family from South Coast Distributing. And that's a good good sign right there. He's walking off the field. A little limp there, but I mean, at least they're not have to carry him off the field.
Yeah, it looks like he's done for the day, though. He's walking gingerly enough. I guess he's not coming back.
You know, the series before, I noticed him getting up slow and stuff, too. So, yeah, it's been a long day for him. Here they go, Tritons. Tritons on the ball real quick. They're ready to go. Wilson with the keeper. Push up the middle, and he's still going. Pick up about 7 yards. That's a first down for the Tritons.
Big first down by the Tritons. And, you know, the Sailor defense, they're expecting run all the way, but it looks like they're just too beat up at this point to do much about it.
Yeah, look at number 55. And
55, Ted Berry. He's made some nice plays tonight, but he's a little gimpy. And
yeah, he's limping around. They're really slow getting up.
The Triton offensive line is really, really taking control of this one and making their presence known at this point.
Yeah,
and
they're
the clock
just
keeps ticking down. Sailors are hanging on to that one timeout.
Pitch to Pasquale. Oh, he almost lost that. No, that's Joey. Joey's with some speed. He's still going. Oh.
Another flag by the Tritons.
Is that on Wilson?
That might have been on Travis Wilson. He was down there in the scrum. And this is dangerous because if Travis Wilson gets kicked out of this game, he can't play next week against West Adams Prep. We still don't know who exactly the penalty was on, but Travis was definitely in the vicinity. That'd be a big blow for the Tritons next week.
Trying to look to my left here to see the Cox screen to see if they show a replay, and they're not showing any replay yet. But they are calling personal foul. Unfortunately, I'm not sure who they called it on. But Wilson is in the game, so.
Okay, so that's 7 15-yard penalties.
So we have confirmed, I think, it is on Travis Wilson.
Personal foul against San Clemente. Football spotted at the 42-yard line of the Tritons. First down and 10.
.229 left in the game. So it's going to be first and 10.
First and 10 for the Tritons. 2 minutes, 25 to go.
Ball at the 42-yard line. Pitch to Nick Pasquale. Oh, nice run. Yeah, this Sailor. Oh, he's still going.
Great run by Nick Pasquale. And this Sailor defense has about had it, in my opinion.
Oh, yeah, you can see. Look at number 7 walking back. Everybody's walking back. 18-yard pickup for Nick Pasquale. We got 2:11 left on the clock. Ball's marked at the 40-yard line.
Clock is stopped while the chains are set. Tritons hustle up to the line.
I think he just let the time tick a little bit here. Yeah, they're holding Travis. They're telling him to hold on.
Yep.
Newport Harbor's got one timeout left, but I think they figure we need two scores. Hand off to Cook.
And there's that fake toss, fullback counter. Only good for about two this time, maybe three.
Steve Michelson and Zach Wade combined on the tackle.
Yeah, you had about a
gain on the play. Football spotted at the 38-yard line. 1 minute, 30 seconds remaining.
Minute and a half to go.
About a 3-yard pickup, yeah. Second down and seven. Ball at the 37-yard line.
In theory, the Sailors could get the ball back, but not with enough time to do what they need to do
scores.
To score. So
no, yeah.
I think we can safely close the fridge on this one. Great Triton victory.
Nice run by Nick.
Not quite to the first down marker. Going to bring up a third and short for the Tritons with about a minute to go. The clock keeps ticking. It looks like Newport Harbor is going
to
hang on to that final timeout.
Yeah, I think you can close the door on this one. How do they used to do it on Monday night? Turn off the lights. The party's over.
Well, you're a little older than me, Jason, so you'd remember better than I would.
Don Meredith. Wilson keeps the ball, takes it to the left.
Hurdles a defender and...
Let me ask you, Mike, did he hurl him? Did he step right over him? Because he's pretty tall.
He probably just stepped. He's about 6'5".
Is it a 25-second clock? Or?
I believe it's 30. In any case,
yeah, well, they're coming up to the line.
They're
yeah.
going to line up in victory formation.
If that's the case, yeah.
For the final snap, if need be.
It's got to be a 25-second. Otherwise, they would have said just that's it. Game's over.
That's it. Thanks to all our viewers tonight. I hope you all enjoyed the broadcast. Rich Corder and Ben should be back next week. But we had a great time. It was a pleasure working with you, Jason.
Yeah, pleasure working with you, Mike. And the Tritons win 24-12.
Yep. So the Tritons go to 5-0, and they head into next week's game against West Adams Prep on quite a roll. And after that, league play begins with Tribuco Hills. So Tritons on a roll. Good to see such a great team with such great kids and great coaches doing some incredible things. One of the best Triton teams I think we've had.
Oh, yeah. 5-0. It's a good start.
All right, good night, folks.
Good night, folks.